Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel guys. If you have a Ford vehicle that does not crank and does not start guys, we'll explain what to look for and what can cause that now guys. Quick introduction guys, we have more than 200 videos guys. Okay, on every car we get at the shop, and we have more than 200 videos on this one here as well. Our mission is to save you guys as much money as we can. So please guys, subscribe to the channel and like the video. We hope that you'll find the information helpful guys, and it will lead you in the right way to the right direction to fix your problem. So we have that 2012 Ford Focus guys that has no intention to start, crank or anything like that. You just turn the key and you're wondering, okay, what's wrong with it? So let me explain to you guys quick. I'll demonstrate so you know what I'm talking about. So I'm inside the car, check it out now. Okay. Nothing guys. So this is guys the scanner that we'll be using. I'm going to show you how we'll diagnose the system and what can cause that now guys, and how to fix it. So guys, a few things that can cause that actually. Now, if the car does not crank guys, okay, it could be the security system that does not let the car start, known as immobilizer or PAT system on Ford guys, passive active entry system, something like that. You have guys a chip inside your key, and if the system doesn't recognize the key, let's say it's a bad key or the system got out of synchronization guys and it cannot remember that key, what will happen? It will not activate the starter. Okay, this is a safety feature so somebody cannot steal your car. However, sometimes, you know, it's a machine, so they will act funny sometimes guys. So it could be a bad immobilizer. There is a reader here that reads it as well, and if that reader is bad, that can cause that as well. So how we'll check that, we'll show you in a second. Second, it could be guys a starter, bad starter. Okay, bad starter will cause the car not to start the same way, no cranking, no starting. However, it could be guys a fuse, it could be relay for the starter as well. We always, almost always have a fuse and relay for your starter, so you need to check those as well. That's another thing guys. And we're going to show you quick here now, okay, how we'll find out what's wrong. And ours is actually pretty simple fix, but we'll show you what to look for. So find your OBD connector, usually it's under the cover or under the dash somewhere. Connect your scanner guys. Okay, and if you want to see where we got our scanner from, check out guys, we have the link, okay, in the description of the video below for your convenience. This is amazing too guys, it works on any car, not just Ford, and it's pretty much dealer level equipment that allows you to read, delete calls from every computer in the car and see live data. The only thing you cannot do is program, but for that price guys, I don't think you can beat that. Check out all the makes and models that it supports. It's simply amazing, amazing to you guys. So all you have to do, click auto detect, turn the ignition switch on. It's going to say Ford USA. We confirm. Now, what you will do, you will actually get the VIN number. We need to confirm this is the correct number. It's going to decode it now, and it will give us what vehicle we have, guys. This will take just a few seconds, and after that we have to confirm that this is the correct vehicle. Yep, 2012 Ford Focus 2.0 direct fuel injection. From that point on, okay, we're just waiting. Now in the top right corner guys, you can notice your battery voltage, 11.5 volts 6. This guys is low. Okay, yep, right there. This is really low. So what I'll recommend, to get a battery charger and connect your battery to the charger. That way guys, you can keep it above 12 volts for secure connection and better diagnostics. Otherwise you can get some funny calls because of low battery voltage. So it should be guys any minute. It usually takes about 20 to 30 seconds. Yep, control unit. Now let me show you quick guys. If you go to PCM, this is the powertrain control module. That's what controls the engine and the transmission in most cases. And you click live data, you can check for codes, see if you have anything. But if you go under live data now guys, okay, I'm going to show you, and you will be able to see if that key is recognized and if we send signal to the starter to enable guys now. Okay, and you can see all the things that you can check here. So let's actually go to, okay, barometric pressure, brake pedal, So you can see how many things we have. Okay, DTC count, crank fueling disabled, yes. Okay. So we keep going down, guys. Okay, right here it says engine cranking. Check it out. It could be under different name, but most of the times it's under engine cranking. And if I turn the ignition key on, it should change to active. Okay, so what I'm going to do. Okay, check it out. I'll just turn the key and it should say active. So that tells us, guys, that the key is actually sending signal, guys, to the starter. It means that, okay, everything's good, key is recognized, so we can go ahead and start. However, guys, something is not letting the car start, so it could be bad starter, fuse, or relay. The first thing to check is always the fuse, guys, and the relay, before you assume you have a bad starter. Also, we have, guys, a video on the channel that explains how to test the starter, which is not very complicated at all. So we will have that on the channel if you want to check it out. It will be there, and you can see all the different things here as well, like fuel pump, fuel pressure, fuel tank, all that stuff, guys. If the pump is on and off, if I circle the ignition, pump will come on and off for a little bit, but I actually disconnected it. Okay, but now let's go ahead and get to the problem. I'll turn the ignition off and I'll show you guys what is causing our car not to start now. So, usually, guys, under the hood you have a fuse box that will have the engine relays and start and fuses as well. In our case, okay, I already started removing it. It's that fuse, guys, that I need to replace. If you need to buy new fuses, guys, okay, we'll have the link in the description of the video below to see where you can get them from. This is our starter fuse, and we have a starter relay as well. So with that fuse being replaced, I want to see now, okay, if the car will start. Sometimes the fuse will burn, sometimes the starter will start going bad, or you crank for a long time, got hot and it burned the fuse. So it really depends, guys, but let's check it out now. Perfect, guys, you can see car started with no problem. So hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.